The same technology we developed for autonomous driving could be used to create these smaller, lighter weight devices like an autonomous scooter or an autonomous wheelchair. We started the research on autonomous wheelchairs about a year and a half ago, and the objective was to bring devices that provide people with personal mobility, and that would make it really easy to go to feed the fish or to go to the doctor or to go visit a friend. All you'd have to do is hop on a chair, point to where you want to go, push go, and the chair would know how to drive you autonomously without the need of a person to push you around. Our system will compute the path, and then it will execute the path. During the execution of the path, the vehicle needs to know at all time where it's located. So it uses the sensors to see the world, and then it matches the features that it sees against the features in the map. So that's how the map is used. The vehicle is also able to detect other people and other unmapped obstacles in real time. We can detect these new objects that may be static obstacles. We can also detect people and other objects and drive around them. I think that could be a very nice collaboration between SMART and US, the hospitals in Singapore and the hospitals in the US, to bring this new kind of technology to hospitals, because the technology will give people much more flexibility and much richer personal mobility, and at the same time it will make it better for the doctors and the nurses who will focus on patient care and will be less worried about whether they have the right objects or the right people in the right place. So it's very exciting. I think that the vehicle is very usable. I think that there is openness by people to use it, to try it. So we're excited about really making it work.